Majjhima Nikaya, and in all the Nikayas, it is considered kind of in some sects that this is the most important sutta, that is Satipatthana Sutta. As Bhante Vimalam Singh teaches us, it is a sutta which has a very important points for our practice. And it has clarifies a lot of things. And Bhante Vimalam Singh has also written a book on Anapanasati that is named Tranquil Wisdom Inside Meditation. So the meditation we are doing is the same meditation, but the object of meditation is different. What we are taking up as object of meditation is not breath, but what we are taking up as object of meditation is metta. Currently we are sending it to our spiritual friend. After that, we can send it into directions based on how you progress. So in that way, you will be able to. I think somebody is stuck outside or something like that. Just somebody can have a look. And this has a unique perspective which Bhante Vimalam Singh gives about the sutta, and it is a unique way of looking at the instructions. So as I told you on the first day, that there are many perspectives to a given teaching. So this is a perspective which will help us in our practice, and whatever we are teaching it from the point of view of helping your practice. And as you have developed and you have been doing good, this is I think third day we have finished. So you have been doing good, and many people are progressing. So this will also help you enhance your understanding of what we are doing from the perspective of this sutta. Thus have I heard, on one occasion the Blessed One was living in Kuru country, where there was a town of Kurus named Kamasatama. There he addressed the bhikkhus thus, students, venerable sir, they replied. The Blessed One said this, student, this is the direct path for the purification of beings, for the surmounting of sorrow and lamentation, for the disappearance of pain and grief, for the attainment of the true way, for the realization of Nibbana, namely the four foundations of mindfulness. So one thing we have to note is that it says that it is a direct path. It does not say that it is the only path or it is the only way. There are this path which the Buddha is teaching. He says that if there are any teaching which has the Eightfold Path and the Four Noble Truths, that path also will lead you to Nibbana. So whoever teaches what is the correct way, you will be able to attain that. What are the four? Here bhikkhus, a bhikkhu abides contemplating the body as body, ardent, fully aware and mindful, having put away covetousness and grief for the world. So what it is saying initially is that you see the body as a body, just that the body is as a body. He abides contemplating feeling as feeling. So whatever feeling you are getting, this is not emotional feelings, these are the sensation. The body has feelings, and the feelings is a part of the contact. When the contact happens, there is feeling. So this is the feeling which it is referring to. Fully aware and mindful, having put away covetousness and grief for the world. He abides contemplating mind as mind. Ardent, fully aware and mindful, having put away covetousness and grief for the world. He abides contemplating mind objects as mind objects. माइंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर शंखारास, और दिस कैन बी थॉट ऑफ एज इन ए सिंप्लीफाइड वे थॉट्स. वॉट एवर थॉट्स कम टू यू आर योर माइंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स बिकॉज दे आर रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन द माइंड. सो देर इज ए काइंड ऑफ ए ओवरलैपिंग विथ द फाइव aggregates also. So there is form, body, then there is feeling, then there is perception, then there is mind objects, and there is consciousness. So those things are also fitting into this four parts of the contemplation or meditation. Contemplation of the body. Now, Bhante is kind of clarifying that contemplation is the word he does not like. He likes observer. So, contemplation makes it look like that you are thinking about it. You are just observing, and that is a part of, big part of our meditation group. The instructions which I am giving also, those things are kind of repeated many times. That you just observe and not get involved in what is coming. And how bhikkhus does a bhikkhu abide contemplative body as a body? Here a bhikkhu gone to the forest or to the root of a tree or to an empty hut sits down, having folded his leg crosswise, set his body erect and established mindfulness in front of him. Ever mindful he breathes in, mindful he breathes out. So now there is one thing is the sitting posture is the posture of people who were there at the Buddha's time. So that does not mean that sitting with a crossed leg is only the correct posture. Whatever way you sit, which is comfortable and is not painful, that posture you have to take. Yes.
What does it mean when it says mindfulness in the front?
Mindfulness in the front means you have to be aware of the mindfulness. So, like we have given you a definition of mindfulness, that is to remember. Mindfulness has memory. So, remember how your mind's attention is moving from one thing to another, how this is an impersonal thing, and how it is causing you dukkha and it is impermanent, and how dependent origination is. That is an adage. That is how dependent origination is involved in all kinds of activities of the mind. So that you have to be remembering. You have to have sati is mindfulness. Mindfulness has memory in it. So you have to remember to do it. And it is giving you the instructions of anapanasati, which is the most common meditation. But in Buddha's, when we analyze this Majjhima Nikaya, the Brahma Viharas, the Metta, Karuna, Mudita, and Upekha, they have been given more times. So Anapanasati is there and Brahma is there. But both have the same method. There is an object of meditation which kind of changes. So we will just see how these instructions are given. Breathing in long, he understands, I breathe in long. Breathing out long, he understands, I breathe out long. Breathing in short, he understands, I breathe in short. Or breathing out short, he understands, I breathe out short. So now we see that the word understand has been used. Breathing in long, one understands that he has breathing in long. So it is not saying to breathe long. Breathing in short, he understands he has breathed. It is not asking you to breathe short. So even if it is short or long, you just understand. So that is what is that we are doing is we are observing what is happening. I shall breathe, he trains thus. I shall breathe in experiencing the whole body. He trains thus. I shall breathe out experiencing the whole body. Now, what is the whole body? Where does the body start and end? It starts from the tip of your head to the soles of your feet. That is your body. So you are aware of this body. when you are sitting in meditation, you are aware that this is a body. I shall breathe out, experiencing the whole body. He trains, I shall breathe in, tranquilizing the body formation. And he trains, thus I shall breathe out, tranquilizing the body formation. So what is tranquilization? The relaxation which we do. In the sixth Vishe, you recognize, release, relax. So this is the relaxed step which is being explained by the Buddha. So what he is saying is, you are relaxing. I shall breathe out, tranquilizing the bodily formation. Just as a skilled lathe operator or his apprentice, when making a long turn, understands I make a long turn, or when making a short turn, understands I make a short turn. So too, breathing in long, a bhikkhu or a student understands I breathe in long. He trains thus, I shall breathe out, tranquilizing the body formation. So, just like somebody who is skilled at the lathe machine or something which is like the, you are doing a drilling. So he understands how this is working, how it is he is doing a long turn or a short turn. That way you understand what is happening. You are not getting involved, you are not controlling. There is no control over here. And there is no stick over here in the instructions. There is no nostrils. There is no abdomen. There is no chest area. There is no area of the breath. There is nothing explained in the what I have read just now. There is no mention of those things. In this way, he abides contemplating body as a body internally, and he contemplates the body as body externally. That just means that he understands what is happening in the body, and he understands what is happening like in the breath. That is the external, in the internal, what is happening internally in the body. So he just understands that, what is happening. So that is also a factor of awareness. Contemplating the body as a body, both internally and externally. Or else he abides contemplating the body, its nature of arising, or he abides contemplating in the body, its nature of vanishing. So we know this part of arising and falling away of the body is more evident when you are going into the arupa jhanas. So when you are in the jhana of infinite consciousness, you will be able to see this more clearly, the arising of the body and the vanishing of the body. And he abides contemplating in the body, its nature of both arising and vanishing. Or else mindfulness that there is a body is simply established in him to the extent necessary for bare knowledge and mindfulness. So he just knows that there is a body. So just he is aware that there is a body. So he is not doing anything but developing the awareness. And he abides independent, not clinging to anything in the world. So there is no attachment. So that's the reason. Whatever arises, you recognize, you release, relax, re-smile, and return back to your object of meditation. So you don't get attached to anything. Any of the thoughts which are coming in, any of the emotions which are coming in, you are thinking this is my emotion. That is the reason the attachment is there. There is an ownership of that. So there is a very small experiment which was done by some social scientists. That experiment is important for us to understand how attachment happens. What they did was they asked the university students to come in a room and said, we will give you a quiz. If you do this 5-minute quiz, we will give you a mug which is for about $5, or a chocolate bar which is for $5. Then everybody came, they did the test. When going, half of them took a mug, half of them took a chocolate bar. So they established that these things are equally desired by the people. So they had the baseline. So next time what they did was, they called the university students in a classroom, said we will give you a quiz and you will get a mug, and everybody can take the mug, sit with your mug beside you and give the quiz and take the mug away. So after the quiz, they brought in the candy, the bars, the chocolate bars, and said the mug is of $5, the candy bar is also worth $5. Anybody who wants to leave now can leave with the mug or exchange it for your candy bar. 80% of them kept the mug. They did not exchange it with the candy bar. Then they said that okay, maybe mugs are more desirable than candy bars. So they did the experiment once again. They called another group of kids. They gave him candy bars before the quiz. They kept the candy bar before that and they wrote the quiz for 5 minutes. After that, they said they brought in the mugs and said, okay, anybody who has finished the quiz can go take the mug and exchange it with your candy bar if you want to. And they found out that 80% of them did not exchange the candy bar. So they said that this possession for 5 minutes of that item, they had not earned it till the time they would have completed the quiz. Okay? And at that point of time, they would have to make a choice. Just because the candy bar was sitting beside them or the cup was sitting beside them, they develop an attachment to that. So how much more attachment we will have for the thoughts which arise in our own mind? So that is the reason we have attachment. So that is the reason we have to be aware. And that is the reason when we are aware that this arises on its own, stays on its own, goes on its own, you realize the impersonal nature of the thoughts which are coming in. Whatever comes up, emotions which are coming in. Like once somebody asks, the emotions are coming in and going. There are different emotions. So yes, they are different emotions, but they come on their own. They stay on their own and go on their own. So the position is, when the thought comes, you say, this is my thought. I had a thought for ice cream. Once teacher told me that somebody explained to him that somebody thought that I want to have a cheesecake. So for the cheesecake, they said, okay, we'll go. But the best cheesecake place is about 5 miles away. So they went, they took out their car, went to that 5 mile drive and came to the shop and find the shop was closed. And then again, they had to return back. And that all happened because just one thought came, I want cheesecake. And because the thought was, there is a cheesecake required, but that was made into personal, I want a cheesecake. And because of that, you or anybody can be going around and around in samsara, because whatever is there, you are considering it personally. So this is how you are by observation finding out that it is just a body.
Sorry sir,
तो अभी ये जो एक्सपेरिमेंट के बारे में है वो मैं बता देता हूँ, वो भी जरा हिंदी में अनुवाद करेंगे. तो ये एक एक्सपेरिमेंट हुआ था कि जब कुछ लड़कों लोगों को बुलाया गया रूम के अंदर और उनको दिया गया एक क्विज 5 मिनट का, उसके बाद में वहाँ पे रखा हुआ था मग और चॉकलेट. उनको बोला कि चॉकलेट भी सब जो $5 का है और मग भी $5 का है, जो लेना है ले लो. तो आधे बच्चों लोगों ने चॉकलेट बार लिया, आधे बच्चों लोगों ने मग लिया. उसके बाद में उन्होंने एक्सपेरिमेंट किया, सब लोगों को बुलाया, पहले ही उन्होंने मग दे दिया उनको और सब लोग मग लेके बैठे और एग्जाम दिया वो 5 मिनट का. और उसके बाद में उनको बताया गया कि आपका ना ये मग $5 का है, आपके पास ये चॉकलेट बार है हमारे पास में, आप मग देके चॉकलेट बार लेके जा सकते हैं. मगर 80% लोगों ने वो चॉकलेट बार जो है वो नहीं लिया, वो अपना पास जो मग था वही मग लेके गए. फिर दूसरी बार उन लोगों ने दूसरे लोगों को बुलाया, उन लोगों को बिठाया और उन लोगों को चॉकलेट बार दिया और बोला 5 मिनट के बाद में कि अभी आप चाहें तो आप चॉकलेट बार दे दीजिए और मग लीजिए, मग का भी $5 है, चॉकलेट का $5 है. मगर अभी भी उन लोगों ने जो 80% जो बच्चे लोग थे उन लोगों ने चॉकलेट बार ही रखा। इसका मतलब क्या होता है कि जस्ट क्योंकि आपका पास में ये 5 मिनट तक रहा, उसके साथ में आपका ये होगा कि ये मेरा है, चिपकाव हो गया। तो जब कोई चीज़ 5 मिनट तक आपके पास रहती है तो चिपकाव हो जाता है। तो अगर आपके मन में ही ख्याल आता है तो वो आपका ख्याल हो जाता है, मगर वो सिर्फ एक ख्याल है। और जब हम कहते हैं कि आपको जो शरीर है उसे सिर्फ शरीर की तरह देखें, तो इसलिए कहते हैं कि ये हमारा शरीर है, ऐसा नहीं देखें, सिर्फ ये शरीर शरीर है और शरीर के बारे में क्या चीज़ें हैं वो आपको बताया गया है। शरीर जो है किस तरह से ये है, और उसके बाद में आनापानासति के बारे में जो इंस्ट्रक्शन दिया गया है वो भी बहुत ही सरल है। उसके अंदर सिर्फ कहा गया था आप जानो अगर आपका श्वास ले रहे हैं तो आपका श्वास धीमा है या तेज है। आपको धीमा श्वास लेने के लिए नहीं कहा गया, तेज श्वास लेने के लिए नहीं कहा गया, सिर्फ आपको कहा गया कि अगर श्वास अगर धीमा है तो आप जानो कि श्वास धीमा है, अगर श्वास तेज है तो आप जानो कि श्वास तेज। सिर्फ जानकारी जो है वो आपको चाहिए। तो सिर्फ हम जो हमारा माइंडफुलनेस जो बताते हैं आपको जो आपका मेडिटेशन के अंदर कि आप जो है जैसा है उसी तरह देखते रहिए, उसको आपको जैसे हमने कहा निर्विचार नहीं होना है, ना ही आपके विचारों को आप संतुलित करना है, सिर्फ देखना है कि विचार है और आपका जो ध्येय है वो ध्येय पे आपको बने रहना है। तो उस तरह से ये बात हुई, फिर आगे हम बताते हैं। और ये इसका जो अनुवाद है वो हमारे अभ्य जी करके दे गए। हाँ थोड़ी थोड़ी मैं बताता रहूँगा क्योंकि फिर क्या होता है कि हमारा मेरा फ्लो चले जाता है उसके हिसाब से। मैं अगर हिंदी में बोलूँ तो पूरा हिंदी में ही बोल सकता हूँ, मगर फिर क्या होता है दोनों में करने में संतुलन करना पड़ता है।
क्या है जो करते हैं ना कुछ छूट जाता है, कुछ बात रह जाती है, जी बताते हैं अच्छी तरह से बताते हैं।
अच्छा।
और हम फिर भी रह जाता है जो आप बता रहे हैं उसी के हिसाब से थोड़ा इंग्लिश में करता हूँ
जितना हो सके मैं करता हूँ। और ये जब बड़ा सुता है तो थोड़ा ये आपको सहना पड़ेगा। एंड ही अबाइड्स इंडिपेंडेंट नॉट क्लिंगिंग टू एनीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड, दिस इज हाउ स्टूडेंट अबाइड्स कंटेम्प्लेटिंग बॉडी एज बॉडी। अगेन बिकॉज अगेन स्टूडेंट्स व्हेन वॉकिंग ए स्टूडेंट अंडरस्टैंड्स आई एम वॉकिंग, व्हेन स्टैंडिंग ही अंडरस्टैंड्स आई एम स्टैंडिंग, व्हेन सिटिंग ही अंडरस्टैंड्स आई एम sitting, when lying down he understands I am lying down, or he understands accordingly however his body is possessed। जब कोई चल रहा है वो सिर्फ ध्यान रखता है कि मैं चल रहा हूँ, अगर बैठा है तो ध्यान रखता है कि मैं बैठा हूँ, वो अगर लेट रहा है तो ध्यान रखता है कि वो लेट रहा है। तो उस तरह से वो जिस तरह से भी शरीर है उस तरह से वो उसका ध्यान रखता है। In this way abides contemplating body as a body internally, externally and both internally and externally, and he abides independent not clinging to anything in the world, means किसी से भी चिपकाव पैदा नहीं करता। That too is how a student abides contemplating body as body। So आप जैसे ये आपका जो शरीर है जैसा है वैसा आपको पता है कि ऐसा है, अगर आप बैठे हैं तो आपको पता है ना कि आप बैठे हैं, बस उतना ही आपका ज्ञान है। सो अभी नाउ दिस इज फुल अवेयरनेस। अगेन स्टूडेंट्स, स्टूडेंट इज वन हु एक्ट्स इन फुल अवेयरनेस व्हेन गोइंग फॉरवर्ड एंड रिटर्निंग, हु एक्ट्स इन फुल अवेयरनेस व्हेन लुकिंग अहेड एंड लुकिंग अवे, हु एक्ट्स इन फुल अवेयरनेस व्हेन फ्लेक्सिंग एंड एक्सटेंडिंग हिज आर्म्स। So what is the full awareness of? He acts when you are sitting, you know you are sitting. When you are standing, you know you are standing. When you are walking, you know you are walking. So what is the awareness of? The awareness is of how your mind is moving from one thing to another. So आपका जब आप बैठे हैं, उठे हैं, चल रहे हैं, लेटे हैं, तो आपको पता है कि आप बैठे हैं, उठे हैं। आप किसके बारे में आपका ये रहना चाहिए? आपका चेतना किसके बारे में रहनी चाहिए? चेतना ये रहनी चाहिए कि आपका मन जो है एक जगह से दूसरी जगह किस तरह से जा रहा है, उसके बारे में आपकी पूरी चेतना रहनी चाहिए। योर अवेयरनेस शुड बी देयर। That is the reason when we ask to smile for doing anything, that helps you keep your awareness. When you are not smiling, then you immediately know that you are not smiling, and your awareness, you can bring it back. So this is how it helps. Who acts in full awareness when wearing his robes and carrying his outer robe and bowl? He acts in full awareness when eating, drinking, consuming food and tasting. Who acts in full awareness when defecating and urinating? Who acts in full awareness when walking, standing, sitting, falling asleep, wake up, take, talking and keeping silent? So whatever activity you do, you can just keep the full awareness, and smiling helps you keep your full awareness. तो आप कोई भी कार्य कर रहे हैं दिन के अंदर, जो अगर साफ करने का काम है, खाने खाने का काम है, सब के अंदर आपको चेतना रहनी चाहिए कि मेरा मन अभी क्या कर रहा है, उसकी चेतना आपको हर समय आपको जारी रखनी चाहिए. इन दिस वे ही अबाइड्स कंटेम्पलेटिंग बॉडी एज ए बॉडी इंटरनली एंड एक्सटर्नली एंड बोथ इंटरनली एंड एक्सटर्नली एंड ही अबाइड्स इंडिपेंडेंट नॉट क्लिंगिंग टू एनीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड दैट टू is how a student abides contemplating body as a body. So, फिर भी आप कोई चीज के ऊपर चिपकाव नहीं पैदा करते. ये this is foulness of the bodily parts. This thing we normally speak skip. बनते also normally skips. ये है अशुभ जो है शरीर के अशुभ जो चिन्ह है उसके बारे में है. वो हमारे बंदे भी वर्मेलमसी जो है वो ये इसको जो है पूरी तरह से नहीं बताते, क्योंकि इसके अंदर कुछ चीज़ें ऐसी हैं जिसके अंदर मन का जो है के अंदर जो है विकार पैदा हो सकते हैं. कुछ एक समय ऐसा हुआ, बुद्ध जो है वर्षावास के अंदर जंगल में वर्षावास बिताने गए, और कुछ भिक्षुओं ने वो गलत तरीके से इसका पालन किया, और वो शरीर से इतना घिन होने लगी उनको कि उन्होंने अपना शरीर त्याग दिया. सो ऐसा हो सकता है, इसलिए वो बोल रहे हैं कि अभी ये अगर इसे करना है तो आपको कोई ऐसे गुरु के साथ करना है जिसका इसके अंदर वो महारत हासिल की है. द फॉलनेस ऑफ द बॉडी इज द पार्ट वेयर वी स्किप इन सतिपट्ठाना बिकॉज देर आर सर्टन एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ इट विच कैन काइंड ऑफ डीस्टेबिलाइज द माइंड एंड वेन एवर यू वॉन्ट टू लर्न दिस इफ यू हैव टू लर्न विद ए एकम्प्लिश्ड टीचर एंड देर वॉज ए स्टोरी और देर वॉज ए सुत्ता वेयर इट हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन दैट वेन द बुद्धा वेंट फॉर अ रेंज रिट्रीट इन द फॉरेस्ट and the monks miss kind of trained themselves with this practice. They kind of had foulness of the body so much that they actually asked somebody to kill themselves, and they discarded their body. And they were a group of it is said in the commentaries that they were a group of devas who had reborn to learn under the Buddha, and now when they were too much disgusted by their body, they wanted to go back to their heavenly abode. So that can be kind of something which can be unbalancing. And the Buddha taught the metta meditation to balance them. और बुद्धा ने metta meditation उनको सिखाया उनको फिर से संतुलन में लेके आने के लिए जो लोग थे. So that is the reason. But it normally means that you see the body in the parts. In the brief, I tell you that what are the parts of the body internally. Like there are lungs there, there are heart is there, the spleen is there, there are fluids in the body. So you just look at those parts, and then there is a charnel ground contemplation. Charnel ground contemplation is in the time of the Buddha, when a relative used to pass away and he is there in the another place, then his body is kept in the charnel ground till the time his relatives come. And that time it used to take a lot of time for the message to go that somebody has passed away and the relative to come. So in that time the body used to decay, and there were stages of decay. So I think 9 stages of decay is explained. So those 9 stages of decay is explained over there. So अभी ये दूसरा जो अशुभ जो भावना है हज के अंदर है ना, जब जो कब्रिस्तान के अंदर वो लोग जो लाश रख देते थे, क्योंकि उनके जो परिवार वाले आके उनको अंतिम संस्कार करना चाहिए, मगर उस टाइम पे बहुत दूर से आना रहता है, तो 6 महीने भी हो सकते हैं, बरस भी हो सकते हैं, उनके परिवार वाले आए, तब तक वो जो लाशें सड़ती थी, तो हर वो लाशें का सड़ने का 7-9 चरण है, वो 9 चरण बताए गए हैं, तो वो सारी चीजें हम करके आगे हम जाते हैं। अगेन स्टूडेंट्स, स्टूडेंट रिव्यूज दिस सेम बॉडी, हाउवर इट इज प्लेस्ड, हाउवर इट डिस्पोज बाय वे ऑफ एलिमेंट्स, मीन्स हम लोग इस शरीर को किस तरह से जो मूलभूत उसकी चीजें हैं उसके अंदर उसके हिसाब से लेते हैं। वी सी दैट इन दिस बॉडी देर आर अर्थ एलिमेंट, द वाटर एलिमेंट, द फायर एलिमेंट एंड द एयर एलिमेंट। सो हम लोग देखते हैं कि ये शरीर के अंदर जो है पृथ्वी का तत्व है, पानी का तत्व है, आग अग्नि का तत्व है और हवा का तत्व है। सो हम ये जो जो भी चीज़ कठोर है उसे हम पृथ्वी का तत्व मानेंगे, जो भी चीज़ के अंदर जो जैसे खून है जो भी बहता है उसे हम पानी का तत्व मानेंगे, जो भी चीज़ के अंदर उष्म है उसे हम आग का तत्व मान लेंगे, और जो भी चीज़ जहाँ पे गैप है जैसे नाक का गैप है, मुंह का गैप है, नाक के अंदर का गैप है उसे हम हवा का तत्व मानेंगे। तो ये सारे तत्वों से हमारा शरीर बना हुआ है। जस्ट एज थ्रू ए स्किल्ड बुचर और ए हिज अप्रेंटिस ए स्किल्ड ए काउ एंड वाज सीटेड इन ए क्रॉस रोड विद इट कट अप विद पीसेस, सो टू ए स्टूडेंट रिव्यूज द सेम बॉडी by way of elements. In this body there are earth element, water element, the fire element and the air element. In this way he abides contemplating the body as body, internally, externally and both internally and externally, and he abides independent, not clinging anything in the world. That too is how a bhikkhu abides contemplating body as a body. So again it is asking you not to have any kind of attachment. So फिर से हम इसे कहा जाता है कि कोई भी चिपकाव पैदा नहीं करना चाहिए किसी भी चीज के ऊपर। यस,
सो इट सेज इंटरनली एक्सटर्नली एंड इंटरनली एंड एक्सटर्नली, व्हाई?
इट इज जस्ट अ वे ऑफ सेइंग दैट हाउ यू आर सीइंग, सो योर अवेयरनेस टू बी देयर फॉर एवरीथिंग, सो व्हाट इज अराइजिंग एंड व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, सो व्हाटएवर इज हैपनिंग टू यू लाइक एक्सटर्नली योर हीट कैन अफेक्ट यू, कोल्ड कैन अफेक्ट यू, internally those thoughts can affect you, emotions can affect you, so all those things you have to be just aware, but you are not trying to control those things, you are just being aware. The awareness is the main underlying factor over here. And then again and again they are saying not to have any attachments. You may be in a very good states of mind also sometimes, and that can be also attachment. You may be in compassion and then you may like that compassionate feeling. Or you may be in sympathetic joy, or this joy is considered to be an enlightenment joy. So you may be kind of attracted to that also. So there is anything which is foul or good, you should not be attracted. But you should be aware that this is there. In this way, he abides contemplating the body. Okay, this is... In this way, he abides contemplating the body as a body internally, and he abides contemplating the body as a body externally. Or else he abides contemplating in this body its nature of arising, or abides contemplating in the body its nature of vanishing. That we will be more clear when you are in the higher jhanas. Or he abides contemplating in the body its nature of both arising and vanishing. Or else mindful that there is a body simply established in him to the extent necessary for bare knowledge and mindfulness, and he abides independent of clinging to the anything in the world. Or जो शरीर है आपको इतना ही पता रहना चाहिए कि ये शरीर है, और आपका जो ध्यान देने का जो जितना है उतना ही आपको उसके ऊपर फोकस करना है या उसके ऊपर दबाव देना है, पूरी तरह से ये फोकस नहीं करना है, मीन्स उसको उतना ही जानना है कि ये है, शरीर है बस उतना ही. इन अबाइड्स इंडिपेंडेंट नॉट क्लिंगिंग टू द एनीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड दैट टू इज हाउ ए स्टूडेंट अबाइड्स कंटेम्प्लेटिंग द बॉडी एज बॉडी कंटेम्प्लेटिंग ऑफ फीलिंग एंड हाउ बिकॉज डज ए हाउ स्टूडेंट्स डज ए स्टूडेंट अबाइड कंटेम्प्लेटिंग फीलिंग एज फीलिंग कंटेम्प्लेटिंग मीन्स ऑब्जर्विंग एज यू सेड कंटेम्प्लेटिंग इज अ वर्ड फॉर ऑब्जर्विंग ही ऑब्जर्व्स हाउ ए फीलिंग इज फीलिंग फीलिंग इज नॉट इमोशंस फीलिंग इज द सेंसेशंस व्हिच हैपेंस इन द बॉडी फीलिंग्स इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द डिपेंडेंट ओरिजिनेशन हियर व्हेन ए फीलिंग व्हेन फीलिंग ए प्लेजेंट फीलिंग स्टूडेंट अंडरस्टैंड्स आई फील ए प्लेजेंट फीलिंग सो ही जस्ट नोज दैट आई फील ए प्लेजेंट फीलिंग व्हेन फीलिंग ए पेनफुल फीलिंग ही अंडरस्टैंड्स आई फील ए पेनफुल फीलिंग When feeling a neither painful nor pleasant feeling, he understands, I feel a neither painful nor pleasant feeling. So, he just understands. So, जब ये हम feeling का बात करते हैं, तो feeling जो है, संवेदना है, जो शरीर में होती है. तो अगर सुखद संवेदना होती है, तो आप जानते हैं कि सुखद संवेदना हुई. अगर दुखद संवेदना होती है, तो आप जानते हैं कि दुखद संवेदना हुई. अदुखद असुखद संवेदना हुई, तो आप जानते हैं कि अदुखद असुखद संवेदना हुई. ना सिर्फ आप जानते हैं कि ऐसा हुआ. When feeling a worldly pleasant feeling, he understands, I feel a worldly pleasant feeling. What is a worldly pleasant feeling? जो भी आप जो दुनियाई जो है सुखद संवेदना है वो क्या है? दुनियाई सुखद संवेदना क्या है? Any feeling which you feel is a worldly feeling which you normally feel. That is a worldly good feeling. So you are in a temperature which is moderate. So that is a good feeling which you get. So you have that temperature is good. So अगर समझो तापमान है बराबर है तो वो अच्छा आपको है मगर वो दुनिया ही है. It is worldly. I feel an unworldly pleasant feeling. I feel a worldly pleasant feeling. When feeling an unworldly pleasant feeling, he understands, I feel an unworldly pleasant feeling. What is an unworldly pleasant feeling? Unworldly pleasant feeling. Yes, very good. That is the thing. In the meditation that you feel that pleasant feeling is. So, जो से अदुनियाई अच्छी भावना है वो आपको जो आपके भावना में मेडिटेशन करते वक्त जो आती है वो आपकी अच्छी भावना है जो अदुनियाई है दुनिया से परे है. आई फील ए वर्ल्डली पेनफुल फीलिंग व्हेन फीलिंग एन अनवर्ल्डली पेनफुल फीलिंग ही अंडरस्टैंड्स आई फील ए अनवर्ल्डली पेनफुल फीलिंग. So what is an unworldly painful feeling?
While meditating, the pain we get.
Yes, correct. So when we are meditating, the pain we get is unworldly. अदुनियाई जो संवेदना है दुखद संवेदना है वो ऐसी है जैसे आप भावना में मेडिटेशन में करते करते आपको कोई तकलीफ होती है आपको दर्द होता है मगर आप उठते हैं तो वो दर्द चले जाता है तो वो दर्द जो है मेडिटेशन का दर्द है तो उसे दर्द को सहना है आपको. यू हैव टू बेयर द पेन विच इज ऑफ मेडिटेशन ऑफ अनवर्ल्डली. व्हेन फीलिंग ए वर्ल्डली नीदर पेनफुल और प्लेजेंट फीलिंग ही अंडरस्टैंड्स आई फील ए वर्ल्डली नीदर पेनफुल और प्लेजेंट फीलिंग. व्हेन फीलिंग ए अनवर्ल्डली नीदर पेनफुल और प्लेजेंट फीलिंग He understands, I feel an unworldly, neither painful nor pleasant feeling. What is an unworldly, neither painful or pleasant feeling? Samatha. That is equanimity. Equanimity is the unworldly, neither painful nor pleasant feeling. Very good. In this way, he abides contemplating feeling as feeling internally and he abides contemplating or observing feeling as feeling externally. He abides observing feeling as feeling both internally and externally or else he abides observing in feeling their nature of arising or he abides contemplating in feeling their nature of vanishing. So, आप सिर्फ जानते हैं कि ये संवेदनाएं हैं और आ रही है संवेदनाएं और संवेदनाएं जा रही है, या इतना जानते हैं कि ये संवेदनाएं है उतना जानते हैं। एंड ही अबाइड्स ऑब्जर्विंग इन फीलिंग देयर नेचर ऑफ बोथ अराइजिंग एंड वैनिशिंग और एल्स माइंडफुल दैट देयर इज फीलिंग इज सिंपली एस्टैब्लिशिंग हिम टू द एक्सटेंट नेसेसरी फॉर बेयर नॉलेज एंड माइंडफुलनेस एंड ही अबाइड्स इंडिपेंडेंट नॉट क्लिंगिंग टू एनीथिंग इन द वर्ल्ड। That is how a student abides contemplating feeling as feeling, contemplation of mind. And how does a student abide observing mind as mind? Here a student understand mind afflicted by lust as mind afflicted by lust, and a mind unafflicted by lust as mind unafflicted by lust. So abhi मन कैसा देखें, तो मन के अंदर अगर समझो लोभ है तो आप जानते हैं कि मन में लोभ है, मन में लोभ नहीं है तो आप जानते हैं कि मन में लोभ नहीं है। He understands mind affected by hate as mind affected by hate and a mind unaffected by hate as mind unaffected by hate। जो मन दोष है तो आप जानते हैं कि दोष है मन में, अगर दोष रहित है तो आप जानते हैं दोष रहित है। He understands mind afflicted by delusion as mind affected by delusion and a mind unaffected by delusion as mind unaffected by delusion। So मोह का भी ऐसा ही है, अगर मन में मोह है तो आप जानते हैं मन में मोह है, अगर मन में मोह नहीं है तो आप जानते हैं कि मन में मोह नहीं है। He understands contracted mind as contracted mind and distracted mind as distracted mind. What is a contracted mind?
Concentrated.
No, it is a mind which is has sloth and torpor in it. So the mind becomes like a brick, and you are not able to do your meditation, your mind goes into sleep. So that is contracted mind. It is a contracted mind is that a mind is in sloth and torpor. That is when you do a little bit of energy into it. You put a little bit of energy, you sit in the open, or you sit straight to give it more energy and openness. What is a distracted mind? You know, the mind is busy. Busy mind is distracted mind. He understands suppressed mind as suppressed mind. Suppressed mind is, what is a suppressed mind?
Suppressing thoughts.
Suppressing thoughts. So you should not put suppress. दबा हुआ दबाना नहीं है किसी को, तो जो मन दबता है तो उसका जो है वो बराबर काम नहीं करता है। अनसप्रेस्ड मीन्स जो दबा हुआ नहीं है, जो अपने आप ही चल रहा है बराबर से। सो यू शुड नॉट सप्रेस द थॉट्स। यू अंडरस्टैंड ए कलेक्टेड माइंड एज कलेक्टेड माइंड एंड अनकलेक्टेड माइंड एज अनकलेक्टेड। कलेक्टेड इज द माइंड विच इज एबल टू लुक एट वॉट एवर इज हैपनिंग वेरी क्लियरली। सो हिज फैकल्टीज आर कमिंग टू वन प्लेस and will be able to observe. So, जब मन जो है एक एकाग्र होता है, एकाग्र बोलते हैं एक साथ में आने का, तो हर एक जो हमारी इंद्रिया है वो एक साथ आ जाती है, तब आपको देखने में आसानी होती है, तब वो कलेक्टेड रहता है। अदर वर्ड इज कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड, बट द कॉन्सेंट्रेटेशन इज यूज इन मेडिटेशन इन मेनी डिफरेंट वेज। सो दैट इज द रीजन आवर टीचर डज नॉट लाइक दैट वर्ड कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड, because concentrated there is a kind of a misuse of that word from our perspective, that it has been used in a way to mean something else. So we use the word collected to kind of give a kind of better, and ekagra in Hindi is more nearer to collected, so that also kind of helps. He understands liberated mind as liberated mind and unliberated mind as unliberated. What is a liberated mind?
Free
in the sense that, see, when you are say, we are giving you the six hour instruction, You recognize, you release, and you relax. When you relax, that concept, the craving which is there, that gets released. That time the mind which is there, that is liberated. That is a mundane way of saying that that is a mundane liberation or a mundane nibbana. And then you smile and then you come back to your spiritual friend. So that time that mind is liberated. And then the other time is when you go into cessation and you attain nibbana. That time your mind is liberated. And that time your mind is giving up those attachments. So those both times. So there is a mundane level where whenever you are doing sikshar, you are letting go of the craving. That's the reason sikshar is very important. You recognize, release, and when you relax, you are letting go of that craving which has come as an attachment to the tension and tightness. When you let go of this tension and tightness, then you have a liberated mind for a brief moment. And then you bring up a smile and your mind is light at that time, and then you start sending it to your spiritual friend or you send it to a direction. Yes.
What is cessation?
Cessation is the part where your mind goes into total shutdown. And in one of the suttas, we will explain the whole process of cessation. There is a sutta we will take up where it will explain how the cessation happens. So in the cessation, it is told that the consciousness is not there. Feeling consciousness is not there in the cessation part. But there is vitality. What is the difference between a man who is in cessation or a person who is in cessation and a person who is dead? Is that the vitality is there in a person who is has cessation. So after some time, the process will start once again. For a person who has lost vitality and heat, that heat and vitality, when a person goes, that is for a person is a dead person. But if you have heat and vitality still, then you are still, but you do not have consciousness or feeling in that state. Then you come back, and that time you have a booting up kind of routine. When you boot up a computer, it shuts down, then it boots up. That time there is certain things you will be able to experience. That is the experience of Nibbana. That time you gain insight, and then you leave something. So when you are have the first experience, we say that you have a Sotapanna path. The second time you have this experience, then you have Sotapanna fruition. When you have Sotapanna fruition, you have given up three things. One you have given up is that you understand that by rites and rituals you will not be able to gain awakening. You give up that attachment to rites and rituals. Then you understand that this is the path which you have taken up. That is the true path, and that is the path which will take you to Nibbana. And the third you understand is you get insight into the impersonal nature of being. You don't totally understand impersonal nature, but you understand that you get insight into it. Only an arahant will be fully kind of rid of the being. Even an anagami will have certain amount of conceit. But totally free of conceit, only an arahant is there. So in the Sotapanna, you get insight into these three things. So these three things are called fetters. So there are 10 fetters. So you get rid of three fetters. And then the next stage is Saktagami. Saktagami, you weaken two more fetters. That is lust and delusion. You kind of weaken those fetters. Then there are five more fetters which are higher, like conceit is there, ignorance is there, wanting rebirth in Devalokas, Ruha, then wanting rebirth in a Rupa, means as a human being, something. And then restlessness. So those five things you give up, those fetters you give up. And then that time you become an arahant. So this is how it progresses from Sotapanna, Saktagami, Anagami, Arahant. So each time there are two experiences. One is for the path, one is for the fruition. When you are in path, you can fall back. But when you have fruition, you cannot fall back. So, after Sotapanna, you have fruition, you will not fall back. So, that is how it progresses. Unliberated mind as unliberated. So, you know what is an unliberated mind. Inside. In this way, he abides contemplating mind as mind or observing mind as mind internally, and he abides observing mind as mind externally. And he abides observing mind as mind both internally and externally, or else he abides observing in mind its nature of arising or its, or he abides contemplating or observing in mind its nature of vanishing, and he abides observing in mind its nature of both arising and vanishing, or else mindfulness that there is mind is simply established in him to the extent necessary for bare knowledge and mindfulness, and he abides independent, not clinging to anything in the world. Now, that is how a student abides observing mind as mind. So, ये चीज़ है मन के बारे में, जो ऐसा ही है कि मन किस तरह से, आपको सिर्फ देखना है कि मन मन की तरह है, वो ही बताया गया है यहाँ पे. Observation of mind objects, the five hindrances. And how students does a student abide observing mind objects as mind objects? Mind objects are sankharas, or you can simplify it as thoughts, because thoughts are also mind objects. Sankhara is a deeper subject, and there are certain subjects which are deep and they have a lot of literature written on it, but we keep it to the practical level. We are giving it to the practical level over here. So in that level, we are explaining what is necessary for your meditation. And there are certain terms like bhava. We translate as habitual tendency in when we come to dependent origination. So those are given in a way that you can understand and you can progress in your meditation. So this is for practical reasons. Here a student abides observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of the five hindrances. So यहाँ पे ये पांच जो हमारे जो अवरोध है, hindrances जिसे बोलते हैं, उसके बारे में बताया गया है कि किस तरह से उसको देखा जाता है, कि आप मन का जो ये है शंखारा जो बोलते हैं, उसे हम विचार की तरह बोलते हैं, क्योंकि वो शंखारा भी एक विचार, विचार भी एक शंखारा है, तो हम उसे विचार भी मान सकते हैं. एंड हाउ डज ए स्टूडेंट अबाइड ऑब्जर्विंग माइंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स एज माइंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ द फाइव हिंड्रेंसेस. हियर देयर बीइंग ए सेंसुअल डिजायर इन हिम, ए स्टूडेंट अंडरस्टैंड्स देयर इज ए सेंसुअल डिजायर इन मी, एंड देयर बीइंग नो सेंसुअल डिजायर इन हिम, ही अंडरस्टैंड्स देयर इज नो सेंसुअल डिजायर इन मी. सो here also you are just aware that this is there. So there also you are not controlling, you are not trying to manipulate it, you are not trying to get rid of it, you are just observing that it is there. So यहाँ पे जो पांच जो अवरोध है, जो sensual desire जो होते हैं, जो भी आपका लोभ है, या फिर आपका दोष है, किसी का घृणा है, वो है. अगर समझो आपको नींद का प्रॉब्लम है, या आपका मन चंचल है, या आपको कोई विचिकित्सा जो उसे आपको डाउट, डाउट को क्या बोलेंगे हिंदी में, शंकाएं है, वो सारी शंकाएं जो है वो है, उतना आपको जानना है, उसको बदलना नहीं है, उसको आपको निकालना नहीं है. अगर वो शंकाएं हैं तो आपको जानना है कि वो शंका है, वो आपका पास में आपका इल विल जो बोलते हैं दोष है, घृणा है, तो वो आप जानना है कि किसी की चीज के ऊपर घृणा है, सिर्फ आपको वो जानना है. एंड ही ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड हाउ देयर कम्स टू बी द अराइजिंग ऑफ अनअरेजन सेंसुअल डिजायर. हाउ डू यू नो हाउ समथिंग विच इज अनअरेजन हैज अराइज अरिजन. सो And he also understands how there comes to be the arising of unarisen sensual desire. So how does one know? और आपको पता चलना चाहिए कि जो चीज घृणा जैसे है या जो लोभ है वो नहीं आई है, वो आने से पहले आपको पता चले। वो कैसे पता चलेगा? नो, बाय डूइंग 6 आवर्स प्रॉपरली। दैट इज द इंस्ट्रक्शन आई हैव बीन गिविंग यू टू द होल डे टुडे। सी, व्हेन यू रिकॉग्नाइज, यू रिलीज, यू रिलैक्स, यू रिस्माइल एंड यू रिटर्न, देन आई आस्क यू, यू हैव टू आस्क व्हाट हैपेंड बिफोर योर माइंड गॉट डिस्ट्रैक्टेड। सो योर माइंडफुलनेस शुड बी शार्प इनफ टू नो व्हाट हैपेंड बिफोर दैट, एंड व्हेन यू नो व्हाट हैपेंड बिफोर दैट, व्हेन यू लेट इट गो, योर माइंड विल नॉट गेट डिस्ट्रैक्टेड। So I'll read it once again. And he also understands how there comes to be the arising of unarisen sensual desire, and how there comes to be the abandoning of arisen sensual desire. What is the abandoning of sensual desires? 6 hours. You recognize, you release, relax, re-smile and return. So अभी इसके अंदर बताया गया किस तरह से, मैंने आज पूरे दिन वो आपको बताया है आपका इंटरव्यूज में भी, कि जब आपका मन भटकता है तो आप क्या करते हैं, पहचानते हैं, उसे जाने देते हैं, यहाँ पे रिलैक्स करते हैं, स्माइल करते हैं, वापस आते हैं, और फिर आपका अपने आप को पूछते हैं कि ये जाने से पहले, मेरा मन भटकने से पहले क्या हुआ। तो मैंने बोला था ना आपका इंटरव्यू के अंदर, मन भटकने से पहले क्या हुआ, तो मन भटकने से पहले क्या हुआ आपको पता चलेगा, तो वहीं पर आप उसे छोड़ देंगे और मन भटकेगा नहीं। तो और जब मन भटकता है तो आपको पता चलना चाहिए कि क्या करना है। तो मन भटकता है तो क्या करना है, सही प्रयास, तो क्या करना है, जब पहचानना है, जाने देना है, रिलैक्स करना है, स्माइल करना है, वापस अपना कल्याण में ले जाना है। तो ऐसा ये कार्य चल रहे हैं। एंड हाउ देयर कम्स टू बी द फ्यूचर नॉन अराइजिंग ऑफ अबैंडन्ड सेंसुअल डिजायर। फ्यूचर नॉन अराइजिंग, हाउ डज इट कम? It comes by you having that experience, the sotapanna experience, the cessation experience, by totally abandoning the fetters. Then there is a non arising in the future. So that is how you progress in this path. There being ill will in him, there being sloth and torpor in him, there being restlessness and remorse in him, there being doubt in him. A student understands there is doubt in me, or there being no doubt in him, he understands there is no doubt in me, and he understands how there comes to be the arising of unarisen doubt, and how there comes to be the abandoning of unarisen doubt, and how there comes to be the future non-arising of abandoned doubt. In this way he abides observing mind objects as mind objects internally, or he abides contemplating mind objects as mind objects externally, or he abides contemplating mind objects as mind objects both internally and externally, or else he abides contemplating mind objects their nature of arising, or he abides contemplating mind objects their nature of vanishing, or he abides contemplating in mind objects their nature of both arising and vanishing. Or else mindfulness that there are mind objects is simply established in him to the extent necessary for bare knowledge and mindfulness. So that again, this has been, I have been telling you that when the thoughts are there, you have to just be aware that the thoughts are there. In the background, the thoughts may be there. There may be thoughts something in the side. You have to just be aware that thoughts are there. You don't have to fight with those thoughts. And you have to keep your spiritual friend before you or in your heart and keep your attention on that. So मैंने बहुत बार आपको बताया कि जो भी आपका विचार आता है, विचारों के साथ झगड़ा नहीं करना है, अनिल विचार होना जरूरी नहीं है, विचारों को आप नियंत्रण करने का जरूरत नहीं है। जब विचार आते हैं तो आजू बाजू से विचार रहते हैं, तो आपको सिर्फ यही पता रहना चाहिए कि विचार है, उसके साथ में आपको झगड़ा नहीं करना है जो भी विचार है। This is how a student abides observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of the five entrances, the five aggregates. So, panch khanda, five aggregates. Again, a student abides observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of five aggregates affected by clinging. Now, this five aggregates affected by clinging should be actually five aggregates when affected by premium. When you are doing a 6 hour, that time you are not having that attachment. So when you are letting it go, relaxing, releasing it, and re-smiling, that time you have no attachment to the aggregates of the aggregate of shankara or the thoughts. You have abandoned those thoughts. So when you are not aware, your awareness is not there, your mindfulness is not there, that time your attachment comes in. When your mindfulness is there, then that attachment is not there. So this statement should be in terms of the five aggregates affected when affected by clinging. And how does a student abide observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of the five aggregates when affected by clinging? Here a student understands such is material form, such its origin, such its disappearance. So such is material form, such its origin, such its disappearance. This is also in part the Four Noble Truths. Such is origin, there is dukkha. Such is its origin. So there is a reason for this, and there is a disappearance. So there is a way, and then there is the fourth part is there is a way. What is that? The eightfold path. So that is, this is there in this is also a part of the Four Noble Truths. And Four Noble Truths is there in dependent origination also. So like in dependent origination, each step can be said to be having these three parts. There is ignorance, there is the origin of ignorance, and there is a disappearance of ignorance. Then there is formations, there is the origin of formation, there is the disappearance of formation. So this can be said, and so each link of dependent origination has these four noble truths. So यहाँ पे ये चार आर्य सत्य के बारे में के हिसाब से बताया गया है कि ये जो है शरीर है, इस शरीर का उद्गमन है, इस शरीर का व्यय है, और इस शरीर का व्यय और उद्गमन का जानकारी का जो मार्ग है वो अष्टांगिक का मार्ग बोलते हैं, तो एट फोल्ड पाथ. तो वो चीज जो है, तो हर एक चीज जो है, जो फोर नोबल ट्रूथ है, चार आर्य सत्य के हिसाब से ये बताई गई है. और जो पतिचा समुपादा, जो डिपेंडेंट ओरिजिनेशन बोलते हैं, उसके अंदर भी हर एक जो लिंक है उसे भी आप ये चार आर्य सत्य के बारे में बता सकते हैं. ये आपका इग्नोरेंस है, ये इसका ओरिजिन है, और इसका सीसेशन है. तो ये इसको आप बता सकते हैं इस तरह से. सच इज मेटेरियल फॉर्म, सच इट्स ओरिजिन, सच इट्स डिसअपीयरेंस. सच इज फीलिंग, सच इट्स ओरिजिन, सच इट्स डिसअपीयरेंस. सच इज परसेप्शन, सच इट्स ओरिजिन, सच इट्स डिसअपीयरेंस. सच आर द फॉर्मेशन, सच देयर ओरिजिन, सच देयर डिसअपीयरेंस. सच is consciousness, such is its origin, such its disappearance. In this way he abides observing mind objects as mind objects internally, externally, and both internally and externally, and he abides independent, not clinging to anything in the world. This is how a student abides observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of five aggregates when affected by clinging. Six bases. Again, तो छह जो हमारे क्या बोलते हैं बेसिस को अपना, सिक्स बेसिस, इंद्रिया छह इंद्रिया. अगेन स्टूडेंट्स, ए स्टूडेंट अबाइड्स ऑब्जर्विंग माइंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स एज माइंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ द सिक्स इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल बेसिस. And how does a student abide observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of the six internal and external basis? Here a student understands the I, he understands the forms, and he understands the fetter that arises dependent on both. So the simple explanation is there should be I and there should be form, and there should be sufficient conditions to be able to see. When the I meets the form, there is a consciousness, I consciousness, which is there. So this is the meeting of the three is called contact. The contact, when there is a contact, there is feeling. So this is a part of dependent origination. 25वां समूहपादा का ये भाग है. ये आँख है और कोई देखने वाली चीज है और ये आँख देखने वाली चीज को मिलती है और उसके साथ में जो विज्ञान है, जो चक्षु विज्ञान है, वो जागता है. वो तीनों चीज का जो है उसको स्पर्श कहते हैं. वो स्पर्श पे आपको वेदना का अनुभव होता है. तो ये वेदना सुखद हो सकती है, दुखद हो सकती है और उस हिसाब से ये 25वां समुपादा का अंग है. वो आगे हम सिखाएंगे. विल गो इन टू डिटेल ऑफ डिपेंडेंट ओरिजिनेशन एज वी प्रोग्रेस. And he understands forms and he understands the factor that arises dependent on both. And he also understands how there comes to be the arising of unarisen factor and how there comes to be the abandoning of unarisen factor. So the factor which is there is attachment is there when there is a feeling which arises and you say this is good or bad. So then that craving arises. So if you are sufficiently observing in your meditation what happens before, what happened before, what happened before, then you will come to a point that when the craving arises, you will come to know the craving is arising and you let go. So that is what he is saying, that he also understands how there comes to be the arising of unarisen fetter. So that fetter does not arise when you are sufficiently observant. And there is a feeling and you let that relax over there and let it go. Then there is no craving. So that is your observation power. So you have to see what is happening before, what is happening before, what is happening before. So आपको देखते रहना चाहिए कि क्या हो रहा है, पहले क्या हुआ, मन भटकने से पहले क्या हुआ. और जब भावना में आप बहुत तीव्र होते हैं और आपकी देखने की शक्ति बहुत तीव्र होती है, तब जब ये वेदना होती है, तब वेदना होते ही आपको पता चलता है कि वेदना हुई. और तब आपका जो उपादान है, जो आपका चिपकाव है, चिपकाव होने से पहले ही आप उसे छोड़ देते हैं, वहाँ पर रिलैक्स करते हैं और वहीं पे वो छूट जाता है. तो तब आपको वो जो चिपकाव भी पैदा नहीं होता. तो ये बताया जा रहा है कि आपको किस तरह पता चलता है कि जब ये कोई चीज़ हुई उससे पहले आपको पता चले. तो आपका देखने का जो ऑब्जर्वेशन का पावर है वो, और वो कैसे होगा, जब आप ये काम करते रहेंगे, 6 आर का काम करते रहेंगे, तब आपका मन का जो देखने का जो शक्ति है वो बढ़ती रहेगी. जैसे मेरा मन पूरी तरह हो गया, उससे पहले क्या हुआ, उससे पहले ये हुआ तो उस तक जाने दीजिए, फिर उससे पहले क्या हुआ, ये हुआ उससे पहले क्या हुआ, मन भटका भटकता उससे पहले क्या हुआ, उस तरह से आप देखते रहेंगे, तब आपका मन का देखने का जो शक्ति है वो बढ़ती जाएगी और आप ये सूक्ष्म चीज़ें हैं वो देख सकेंगे और उससे आप उपादान होने से पहले ही आप उसे छोड़ सकते हैं. तो आपका मन की शक्ति बढ़ानी है. सिर्फ आपको ये जो हम सिखाया जाता है वो सिर्फ बैठ के करना नहीं, आपको जीवन में भी ये करते रहना है, तभी ये आपको फायदा है. सो दिस इज नॉट ए प्रैक्टिस जस्ट फॉर सिटिंग, this is also a practice in life. That's the reason we encourage you for the meditation, and we encourage you to do it in all activities which you are doing. So a smile is a good starting point. So muskurate rehna wo ek sahi shuruaat hai. So muskurate raho aur phir aap aage iske andar aapka man ka jo ye hai, kyunki aap muskurate hai, aap nahi muskurate tabhi aapko pata chalta nahi muskuraye, phir muskurate to aapka yaaddaasht ki shakti badhti hai. और आपको हर समय आपका जो मन जो है, जिसका चेतना है, वो आपकी रहती है. नो यू शुड ऑलवेज स्माइल. दिस इज ऑल फंडामेंटल टू आवर प्रैक्टिस. एंड ही अंडरस्टैंड फॉर्म्स एंड ही अंडरस्टैंड्स द फैक्टर दैट अराइजेस डिपेंडेंट ऑन बोथ एंड ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड हाउ देयर कम्स टू बी द अराइजिंग ऑफ द अनअरिजन फैक्टर एंड हाउ देयर कम्स टू बी द अबैंडनिंग ऑफ द अनअरिजन फैक्टर. So and how there comes to be the future non-arising of the abandoned fetter. He understands the ear, the nose, the tongue, the body, the mind. He understands mind objects and he understands the fetter that arises dependent on both. And he also understands how there comes to be the arising of unarisen fetter and how there comes to be the abandoning of an arisen fetter, and how there comes to be the future non-arising of the abandoned fetter. In this way, he abides contemplating, or he abides observing mind objects as mind objects internally, externally, and both internally and externally, and he abides independent, not clinging to anything in the world. That is how a bhikkhu or a student abides contemplating mind objects as mind objects in terms of the six internal and external bases. The seven enlightenment factors. Again, a student abides observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of the seven awakening factors. We call it awakening. Enlightenment is a kind of a nitpicking. But my teacher likes the word awakening, because what he thinks is that enlightening means that if you don't know something and I tell you something, that you are enlightened about that aspect. So he prefers the word awakening. So we will use the word awakening. Seven awakening factors. And how does a student abide observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of seven awakening factors? Here, there being a mindfulness awakening factor in him, a student understands there is a mindfulness awakening factor in me. So that again there is just an awareness that this mindfulness is there. So there is also again an awareness. There is again and again emphasis on being aware. तो अभी इसके अंदर क्या बताया गया है, सात ऐसे चीज़ें हैं जिसे आपका जो निर्वाणा के लिए आपको फायदा होता है. उसके अंदर पहला चीज़ है माइंडफुलनेस, जो सती बोलते हैं. तो सती आपके अंदर है, तो आपको ये जानना है कि ये सती है, ये चीज़ हमारे अंदर मौजूद है. तो बार बार ये चीज़ बताया गया है कि आपका जो चेतना है वो चेतना जागरूक रहनी चाहिए. आपको पता रहना चाहिए क्या हो रहा है, अभी क्या हो रहा है, वो आपको बार बार पता रहना चाहिए. आपको उसके बारे में बोध रहना चाहिए. सो अभी ये अलग अलग जो सात जो है उसके बारे में बताएंगे. देयर आर अदर फैक्टर्स ऑल्सो. देयर इज नो माइंडफुलनेस एनलाइटनमेंट फैक्टर इन मी, एंड ही ऑल्सो understands how there comes to be the arising of the unarisen mindfulness enlightenment factor, and how the arisen mindfulness enlightenment or awakening factor comes to fulfillment. Arisen mindfulness awakening factor comes to fulfillment by development. There being the investigation of states awakening factor in him, there being energy awakening factor in him, there being the rapture awakening factor in him, there is also called sometimes joy awakening factor, there being the tranquility awakening factor in him, there being the collectedness awakening factor in him, there being the equanimity awakening factor in him. A student understands there is the equanimity awakening factor in me. Or there being no equanimity awakening factor in him, he understands there is no equanimity awakening factor in me. And he also understands how there comes to be the arising of unarisen equanimity awakening factor, and how the arisen equanimity awakening factor comes to fulfillment by development.
Okay.
Yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
What is the difference between
PT
and Prasati?
PT, Prasati, I told you that initially that it depends on the level of excitement. So joy has a little bit more excitement, and tranquility has a little bit of less excitement. But they are very similar emotions, and then equanimity has the least amount of excitement. So you see in the graph, it is coming as joy, tranquility, then equanimity comes because of the level of excitement. So as you go ahead in this chart, you come to equanimity because there is no excitement over here. There is a balance. And then sometimes people don't like this balance because they are used to this excitement. You know, there is something playful over here in tranquility also. There is more something playful over here in joy. But when you understand tranquility, then these things become a little troublesome. So Buddha also says that when you achieve something high, then going back to something low will be a little troublesome. So you have to always aim for going higher in this path. In this way, he abides observing mind objects as mind objects, internally, externally, and both internally, externally, and he abides independent, not clinging to anything in the world. That is how a bhikkhu or a student abides observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of the seven awakening factors, the four noble truths. Again, a student abides observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of the four noble truths. And how does he, a student, abide observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of the four noble truths? Here, a student understands as it actually is. This is suffering. He understands as it actually is. This is the origin of suffering. He understands as it actually is. This is the cessation of suffering. He understands as it actually is the way to the leading to the cessation of suffering. तो ये चार आर्य सत्य के बारे में बताया गया है. तो चार आर्य सत्य जो है वो भी आपको सिर्फ जानना है कि ये दुख है, ये इसका शुरुआत इस तरह से होता है, इसका अंत इस तरह से होता है, और ये एक मार्ग है, उस मार्ग से चलने पे इसका आपको पता चलता है. तो हम जो सिखा रहे हैं वो उसके अंदर अष्टांगी मार्ग का पूरा आपको सीखने मिलता है. तो जब अगर आप जो हम जितना कहते हैं सही प्रयास करते हैं तो पूरा जो अष्टांगी मार्ग है पूरा करते हैं इसके अंदर. तो यहाँ पे शील का पालन करते हैं, समाधि का पालन करते हैं, शील समाधि और पन्या जो है जो आपको जानकारी मिलती है आप खुद देख के. तो सारे शील समाधि और पन्या ये जो आप कार्य करते हैं उससे आपको मिलता है. सो व्हेन यू आर डूइंग दिस प्रैक्टिस यू आर फुलफिलिंग द फोर नोबल ट्रूथ्स एंड द एट फोर पाथ. सो यू गेट टू नो अबाउट द कंडक्ट विच यू आर एज पर प्रिसेप्ट्स यू आर कीपिंग द प्रिसेप्ट. Then there is the meditation, and then there is wisdom. Wisdom is the one you are seeing for yourself and understanding. That is the wisdom part. In this way, he abides observing mind objects as mind objects internally, or he abides contemplating mind objects as mind objects externally. Or else, mindful that there are mind objects is simply established in him to the extent necessary for bare knowledge and mindfulness, and he abides independent, not clinging to anything in the world. That is how a student abides observing mind objects as mind objects in terms of the four noble truths. Students, if anyone should develop these four foundations of mindfulness in such a way for 7 years, one of two fruits can be expected for him. Either final knowledge here and now, or if there is a trace of clinging left, non-return. So, if you practice this for 7 years, you are promised one of the two fruits. One is non-returner, means you are not returning as a human being, or you are totally getting awakened and becoming a aham and understanding the whole process. तो इन्होंने कहा, बुद्ध कहते हैं कि अगर आपने 7 साल तक इस तरह से आपने प्रयास किया तो आपको दो फल मिल सकते हैं. एक फल है कि आप जो है अनागामी होंगे, तो आपको एक मनुष्य की तरह पैदा नहीं होना पड़ेगा. आप देवलोक में जाएंगे, वहां पे से ब्रह्मलोक में जाके वहां से आपका उद्धार होगा, और या आप जो है यहीं पर आप अरहंत बन जाएंगे. तो 7 साल के अंदर आप ये कर सकते हैं. दैट इज प्रॉमिस फॉर 7 ईयर्स. देन द बुद्धा सेज इवन इफ यू डू इट फॉर 6 ईयर्स, इवन इफ यू डू इट फॉर 5 ईयर्स, इवन इफ यू डू इट फॉर 4 ईयर्स, इवन इफ यू डू इट फॉर 3 ईयर्स, इवन इफ यू डू इट फॉर 2 ईयर्स, इवन इफ यू डू इट फॉर 1 ईयर, लेट अलोन 1 ईयर, इवन इफ यू डू इट फॉर 6 मंथ्स, इवन इफ यू डू इट फॉर सेवन डेज, इवन इफ यू डू फॉर सेवन डेज यू कैन हैव दिस. सो यू हैव सेवन डेज नाउ इन दिस रिट्रीट. सो मे बी सिक्स डेज, बट कंसिडरिंग यू कैन कंसिडर इट एज सेवन डेज एंड स्टिल यू हैव टाइम टू have this two fruits. And this has happened with my teacher at least, not with me, but my teacher, that students have come and within these 10 days they have gone very far. And this has happened not once but a few times with him. So this can happen if you sincerely practice and you sincerely keep your attention on what your object of meditation is. If it is directions, then directions. If it is somebody in front of you, that is your spiritual friend, then spiritual friend. You can keep your spiritual friend in your heart also. So इस तरह से बुद्ध कहते हैं कि छः साल, पाँच साल, दो साल, एक साल, सात दिन भी अगर आपने ये किया तो भी आपको ये दो फल में से कोई फल आपको मिल सकता है. तो अभी सात दिन अभी है तो आप उसमें आप काट ही
दीजिए. एटलीस्ट बन के सोता पन्ना तो बनेगा,
सोता पन्ना तो बन के जाए.
देयर
इज नो डेस्पिरेशन, देयर इज ए अंडरस्टैंडिंग. सी इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड समथिंग लाइक बुद्धा सेज वेरी सिंपली इन द सिमिली ऑफ द पॉइजन, यू नो. सो ही सेज दैट से इफ देयर इज अ कप of poison over there and there is a cup of medicine and you are given a choice, what would you choose? You will choose the medicine because that will be helpful to you. So that is the only thing which starts the whole process with ignorance. When we are going into the teaching of dependent origination, you will see that it starts with ignorance. The whole cycle starts with ignorance. That is a way of explaining, but there is something before ignorance also it comes. That is for another day, but it starts with not knowing. So when you know that this is something which is hurting you, then you will stop doing that. So this is the way of revealing to yourself what is the truth. So when you reveal yourself with the truth, that is your wisdom, that is your knowledge. And what is happens is this seeing is who's doing the seeing. That is you yourself are doing the seeing. So there is no desperation or there is no clinging to that. But you should have an address where you want to go. So that amount of means that amount of craving has to be there. So like I have this piece of paper with an address and I want to go to say the Kalimpong market. So I have this address and I go and I will come to the shop. Then would I need this address? This is a very small thing. So I will just leave it and I am at the destination. So the craving for Nibbana is also like this, craving for having this address. So that amount of craving is required. Because if you do not have a path or you do not have a goal, then how would you walk? Too much is bad. So that is the reason Buddhism is always on balance. If you are too much into it, then that is bad. That same thing in balance, then there is an Persian doctor who says that anything in the world in balance can be medicine. So a poison of a snake is also medicine. Why? Because it is in balance, it is used. When you have cobra bite you, what is the medicine given? Is a cobra's venom. So even a snake's poison in balance is medicine. So everything has to be in balance. And that's what we are teaching you. That not to sit very comfortably also, not to sit in painful way also. Sit in a middle. And the pain is there, you should not avoid all pain also. If there is a meditation pain, you have to endure that meditation pain. So that is, and if it is physical pain, don't ignore that also. So it's everything is a balance. So you have to continue gaining insight into that. And how you can gain insight is just by looking at this process. That is how you can proceed. There are, I think, a lot of questions today. Why there is boredom during meditation? How to solve this problem? See, why is not don't answer, because why is a very big question, because why has perception in it. When something comes with a perception, that means that you have to go into how this perception was created. To know that, you may have to kind of analyze your back life, and that may not be enough, and then you may have to analyze your previous life. Then if that may be not enough, you have to analyze more previous lives. Once Buddha said that if four of his students, bhikkhus, sat and recollected 100,000 lifetimes as human beings in one day, and they did this for 100 years, they would still not be able to have finished their task. So there are so many lifetimes. So how can we analyze the why? Why is not the analysis we do? We do the analysis of how. How the boredom arises. That's the reason we ask, when this happened, what happened before that? So when the boredom came, what happened just before the boredom came? So how was your body and mind when the boredom came? Were you kind of interest went away from your spiritual friend? So then you, whenever the interest is going away, you put in more interest. So then you know that what is the origination of the boredom, and then before that boredom comes, you are letting it go. So that is how you kind of work with this thing. Sometimes when I am focused in the feeling of metta, my spiritual friend disappears. How to solve it? Don't worry about your spiritual friend disappearing. Just remember your spiritual friend, bring back your spiritual friend in your heart. Some people are not visual. So don't kind of worry about not visualizing the spiritual friend. That is not kind of a thing. If you are not visual, okay. Just feel the spiritual friend, as if the spiritual friend is in your heart. Some people can visualize the spiritual friend just being beside them, or walking when they are walking in meditation. So whatever works. Now there is third question. No, this is the
question. Sir, when there is a feeling of metta and I am, you know, giving it to my spiritual friend, slowly I am focused on feelings, but then I realize that, you know, I am focused on that feeling, I am feeling that feeling, but I am not giving it to them.
No, don't worry about giving. That giving part is automatic. So you focus on your, and that goes on the own. And you are, there is no pushing and pulling on that part. There is no pushing and pulling. Just feel it and don't worry about it going to the person. Just feel it and be with this feeling of it. How do we know that we have progressed? That we have done, no? Yesterday. Okay. Is the silence in between the sessions mandatory? Yes, it is mandatory. Because silence is mandatory because your mind gets disturbed when you are talking, and every talk which you do has associations with other things. So when you talk about, say, the heat or the cold or anything, it is associated with many other things, and many other topics come up. Or maybe you are just talking about the past, so the past comes up. If you are talking about the future comes up. So that is the reason silence is required in the retreat. The whole time you have to have silence. तो मौन रखना जरूरी है, तो हाँ जरूरी है. आपका जो भी बात होती है, बातों से बात निकलती है, और एक के बाद एक आपका बात निकलती जाएगी, और मन जो है आपका और कार्य करने लगता है. तो उस तरह से आपको बातें नहीं करनी है. अगर आप साथ में भी है तो आपको बातें नहीं करनी है. अभी 7 दिन के बाद बात करना है. ओके, सो दैट इज वेरी मैंडेटरी. आई फील सरप्राइज माय कन्वर्सेशंस एवरीवेयर. ओके, I feel surprised now. I feel this time is an unique chance to go within and find all the answers there. Correct, I also agree. The noise around is disturbing to me. So that is what I am trying to say, that this is disturbing to somebody else. So you may talk and disturb yourself, but that your talking is disturbing somebody else. So you should not disturb somebody else. It is a silent retreat. you have to ensure that you do not talk, and that does not mean that you go down to the pagoda and then start talking over there. You, then also, there is two people who are getting disturbed, yourself and the other person. So that should be very clear. What is your stand on that? I have made my stand. The role of woman and the female, feminine in Buddhism. See, there is no feminine or male in Buddhism in such, as such. See, in Thailand, actually, the monks and nuns are considered to be different genders. They are considered to be third gender and the fourth gender. Or sometimes they are considered to be the third gender. So there is, gender is not a very important thing in Buddhism. The basic factors of whatever we have explained has not been explained in the factor of gender. See, sometimes the Buddha was asked about the female gender and then he replied in that manner. And that same thing was asked about the male gender and he replied the same thing. See, there are one thing which was asked that what is attractive to a female gender. The Buddha said that the male is attracted to a female gender. Then he was asked in a separate occasion what is the most attractive thing for a male gender. So Buddha said the female is the most attractive. So there is no distinction over here. So that is the kind of way of just asking sometimes, and then they nitpick about that. But there is independent origination, there is no dependent origination for females, there is no dependent origination for males. In the Four Noble Truths, there is no female Four Noble Truths, or the instructions which are given, there are no male instructions or female instructions. So the process which is there is the same. And in the cycle of life, in samsara, also there is no you may have been sometime you may have been a male, sometime you may have been a female. So one of the ways Buddha says is, if you meet somebody in the world, the person may have been your mother or father. So that is how much time you have spent in the samsara, and that is how the gender which is there is irrelevant. Because you have been born and means millions and billions of time as male and millions and billions of time as female. This time we are male or female. That does not make any difference in the way your mind is working. The basic process of the mind which is there remains the same. Do you see shifts happening around the topic? I don't see this topic as important other than in some circles where bhikkhuni and the nun in Theravada has become a kind of a concern. So that is the only thing where there is a discussion about the male and female. And there are certain rules the Buddha had asked for the bhikkhunis, the female, the nuns who ordained. And that was as per the time. The Buddha has given 10 reasons for any rules which he gives. And some of the reasons is social cohesion. So that time the social society situation was such. But that does not mean that there is any distinction he has made in that. So some certain things have been kind of over analyzed. But as such, in Theravada or the teaching of the Buddha, any teaching is not based on gender. So every teaching which is there is based on the subject matter, which is the attachment. That the Four Noble Truths is followed. So many of the teaching will point out the Four Noble Truths. So that is the thing. So I don't consider that a big thing. And please explain staying with the spiritual friend. Staying with the spiritual friend means that you are always sending the spiritual friend metta. So as we explained just now, it can be not visible also, but you may just know that your spiritual friend is there, and then you are staying. Because you are staying with your spiritual friend, that is how you know your mind is going from one thing to another. And what happened before that mind has gone from one thing to another. Somebody today in the interview mentioned that they have noticed what happens just before the mind goes off. So that time, if they do this 6 hours, then your mind will stop. But then you can ask what happens before that happened. also. Then you know more and more, deeper, more and more refined. This dependent origination, we will teach you a 7 steps chart. That 7 step chart will tell you how this will go and how you can find out what, when it has happened. And when you are gone to the level of the feeling, which is kind of highest, there are very few meditators. I can also not claim to know when the I can recognize when the feeling is coming. That is very refined. But when that feeling, when it comes, there are meditators who can recognize that and release it. So there is no craving also coming in. So that is how you can enhance yourself, but just by being with your spiritual friend. Well, that is the start. That is the start of the practice. What is the difference between sleep and deep sleep? That we have done, no? Can I personally talk to you on Dhammapada verse 3 and 4? Yes, you can. Maybe after this you can talk to me about that. Is there any other questions? Yes.
Bhakti, what is the difference between Samatha and Samadhi?
Samatha and Samadhi, there is a how it is mentioned in the this thing. It is a little complicated subject. So see, Samatha is what we say for tranquil wisdom, okay? And Samadhi we use for the collectedness of the mind. So tranquil wisdom can be said to be the path we follow to get to the mind which is collected. So our meditation itself is tranquil wisdom inside meditation, that is Samatha and Vipassana. So both are required in your practice. The result or the state in which you can come is the Samadhi, state of Samadhi. But this state of Samadhi is in the Indian system is considered to be a different way. It is more permanent and more solid in that sense. But in the way of the Buddhists, it is collected, ekagrata. Yeah. So that is more near to that samadhi.
So ekagrata is samadhi.
Ha, that samadhi is that. Yeah, samadhi is that. That has a part of that. Ekagrata has samadhi has a part of ekagrata, and that is how we are kind of trying to explain. That has a little bit lighter because your mind is still moving. When you are in samadhi, mind is totally in the system, which is the other systems. Samadhi is denoted by a mind which is totally absorbed in its object of meditation, or it is the final stage where nothing else is happening, but not in the way the Buddha is teaching. So that's a very subtle difference. Any other question? Yes.
Guruji, in your sutras, you read about feelings and mind.
See, the brain is kind of a complicated subject. See, happens is that once the Buddha was asked, where does the mind reside? So, is it in the body? The Buddha says, we cannot say that, Ananda. And then Buddha was asked, is it outside? He said, we cannot say that, Ananda. Is it inside and outside? We cannot say that. So we cannot say something definitive because that is a little bit a subject which is not conducive to the progress of the path. So when there is certain questions which does not help you in progressing in the path, the Buddha does not answer that. There are many other questions also in the same way the Buddha does not answer. So there is I think 8 questions which are there asked by ascetics regularly. And the Buddha says you cannot say that. If the Tathagata is there or Tathagata exists or not, after the years, Parinibbana and all those speculative questions.
Now that means feeling and mind is the same thing or different?
See, what you have to understand is there is a feeling. You understand that there is a feeling. There is a mind, you understand there is a mind. It is a part of the mind, you can say. The feeling and the thoughts, sankharas, are all part of the mind. So this is a kind of technical question, so it does not help in the basic overall. So don't get too much involved. What you have to do now, focus on is your spiritual frame and the right effort. So you are sending to your spiritual frame and you are doing the right effort. You recognize, you release, you relax, you smile, return. You just keep on doing that and you will be able to progress. And those certain things which you have questions, when you progress, you will automatically get the clarification of that also. Because certain questions we cannot give you as an information. Certain questions you have to have it as an inspiration. And sometimes you have, as of now, you have 3 days, you have already done the meditation. So you have to, whenever there is a persistent issue, you can also do one thing is ask your intuition. That if there is a persistent issue, then you can ask once, why is this happening? And then let the intuition come with the answer. Then sit in meditation normally, why is my mind so busy? Just ask once and let it go. अगर आप अभी 3 दिन आपने मीन्स भावना की है तो अगर कोई चीज़ बार बार आपको तंग कर रही है तो अभी आपको जो है आपका आपको पूछना है मेडिटेशन में बैठने से पहले आपको पूछना है कि ये क्यों हो रहा है, मेरा मन इतना क्यों भटक रहा है, या फिर मुझे द्वेष की भावना इतना क्यों आ रही है, उसको एक बार पूछना है और फिर आपको छोड़ देना है और उसे जो जवाब है उसको आने के लिए आपको राह देना है। तो जैसे जैसे आप मेडिटेशन करेंगे आपको जवाब आ सकता है, तो उस तरह से आपको अपने आप से पूछना है। सो दिस इज द टाइम यू हैव टू डेवलप योर इंट्यूशन। एनी अदर क्वेश्चन?
सो व्हेन वी गेट डिस्ट्रैक्टेड यू सेड दैट वी कैन गो बैक एंड सी व्हाई वी गॉट डिस्ट्रैक्टेड, हाउ वी
नॉट टू गो बैक, यू हैव टू हैव योर अवेयरनेस शार्पन. So when your mind was distracted, you release, relax, re-smile and return, and now you have to have the sharpness of observation to see what happened just before your mind gets totally distracted. So that sharpness, awareness is the one you have to develop.
So what step is that? Is that recognize?
You recognized, you released, you relaxed, you re-smile, you return to your object of meditation. By doing this, sending metta to your spiritual friend, you have to be sharp enough to know what happened before this mind totally went. Sometimes you may have this, there are thoughts over there, you are going oscillating between thoughts and sending metta, oscillating between thoughts and sending metta. That is your maybe cue point. Then you know this is happening, then that time you relax, be smile, and again you focus on your, take more interest in your. Then this does not pull you away. Then you know that this oscillating which happens, that is the time you are to pay more attention, take more interest in your spiritual friend. So that is how you know this has happened. Now what has happened as you know, but before it oscillates, what happens? Then you have to be curious about the next step. Then you have to be curious about the next step. What happens before that? That way your sharpness keeps on growing about what is happening. No. We are not getting curious, we are becoming aware. Not curiousness, awareness. This is all, the whole sutta was basically be aware. One word we can be, if you have to summarize the sutta, be aware. Awareness is the main thing. If you are aware, this is there, and not to fight with anything which comes. There is no fighting. There is no getting rid of anything. ये जो अगर हम सुत्ता को एक शब्द में कहें तो चेतना में कहेंगे, ये चेतना आपकी रहनी चाहिए, चेतना जितना रहेगा उतना आपको पता चलेगा. सो दैट इज हाउ यू डेवलप. इट टेक्स टाइम बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट आर योर हैबिचुअल टेंडेंसीज. वी गो टू डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, वी विल कम टू नो अबाउट दैट. So if your habitual tendencies are more, then it takes a little more time. But it is something where each time you do 6 hours, you are taking away energy from your hindrances. So हर एक बार जो आप सही प्रयास करते हैं तो आप जो उसका जो ऊर्जा है आपका जो मन को विचलित करता है उससे ऊर्जा लेते हैं और उसको आप कमजोर बनाते हैं। जितना आप उसको ध्यान देते हैं उसके अंदर उसको आप ऊर्जा देते हैं और उसको और प्रबल बनाते हैं। तो आपको ऊर्जा लेनी है जिस जो भी आपका मन भटकाता है, और ऊर्जा किसमें देनी है, आपका कल्याण मित्र को देनी है। तो कल्याण मित्र में जितना इतना ध्यान देंगे फिर आपको आगे बढ़ेगा, तो फिर और हम मेडिटेशन ऑब्जेक्ट देंगे और अलग अलग होगा, उस तरह से होगा। और एनीथिंग एल्स? ओके, देन वी शेयर द मेरिट्स। May suffering once be suffering free, and the fear struck fear is easy. May the living shed all grief,